It's an open secret that military recruiters prey on more teenagers than Jason Voorhees at a Hot Topic. Yes, recruitment offices are notorious for promising big, fat, juicy macaroni and a pot-style bonuses of $20,000 and all kinds of cushy special treatment if you just sign on the dotted line. While they'd never admit to lying, these recruiters massage the truth more than a Hitachi wand, from threatening prospects with prison time for not keeping appointments, providing fake high school diplomas, taking kids to go buy detox pills to hide drug use, and even providing a possible enlistee with laxatives to help him lose weight and pass a military physical. You too can shit your brains out for your country. But if you thought all that was insane, how about the fact that the military has developed and published not one, not two, but six video games as recruitment tools targeted at children? The military has even recently moved into Twitch streaming, where they're running fake contests for controllers that took you to a webpage with no mention of a contest, just a recruitment form. Almost all the branches of the military have these esports teams, and the Army has a huge presence in advertising in esports. So recruitment is big business for the military, and the younger they can influence kids, the better the shot they feel like they have. Really taking the Michael Jackson approach to building a military. Which checks out, as some recruiters have even used their position and access to high schools to sexually assault high schoolers. And some recruiters have even set up fake Tinder accounts to catfish recruits. A staff sergeant in the Air Force said, "Recruiters are unethical liars and manipulators by trade." And even though we all kinda know that the military recruiters are dishonest, I think a lot of people would be surprised by the depths that the dishonesty takes. So in this video, we're gonna dive deep into the most dishonest recruitment tactics the military uses. So let's start where most troops do. Recruitment.
If you could say one thing to your recruiter, what would it be?
That's fucking bullshit.
If you could say one thing to your recruiter, what would it be?
Why the fuck did you lie to me?
If you could tell one thing to your recruiter, what would it be?
Fuck you.
If you could say one thing to your recruiter, what would it be?
Fuck you.
If you could say one thing to your recruiter, what would it be?
I hope he dies.
I mean, there clearly seems to be a consensus of regret among these guys. I mean, this TikTok gives us a rare glimpse into how these troops actually feel at this point in their training. While most military TikToks are pure cringe.
He's a recruiter. Never lies. He's honest, integrity, caring, compassionate. He's a recruiter.
Other TikToks are providing a raw and real look at how much the military fucks over individuals after they join.
Why are you joining the Army?
$20,000 bonus that I never received.
Yeah, yeah.
Shit.
I mean, look, far be it from me to criticize the military's methods, although I don't understand how this could possibly be effective. Imagine answering that phone and you're just like, "Hello? Hello? Who's there? Hello?" Well, let's back up a bit. Let's take a look at the recruitment offices themselves and the recruiters. Now, back in 2006, the Army got caught by a high school journalist who launched a sting operation into the recruitment tactics the Army was using and the lengths that the Army recruiters would go to meet quotas. 17-year-old journalist, honor roll student, and certified pussy crusher David McSwain reached out to his local Army recruitment office with a scenario.
For one thing, he told this recruiter he was a dropout and didn't have a high school diploma. No problem, the recruiter explained. He suggested that David create a fake diploma from a non-existent school. David even recorded him saying that on the phone.
Be like a Faith Hill Baptist, you know, school or something, or whatever you choose.
And David fucking followed through. This little badass went online, got a fake diploma, along with fake transcripts, and even used the fake school name that the recruiter suggested. David even upped the ante, also claiming that he was addicted to marijuana. You know, how that happens.
The recruiter claimed in another recorded phone conversation, taking these detoxification capsules and liquid would help David pass the required test.
He says, "Not a problem. Just take this detox." He said he would pay for half of it.
The two times that I've had the guys use it, it's worth both times. We didn't have to worry about anything.
Now, the recruitment officer, Sergeant Pickle, which he must have been so happy when people finally stopped calling him Private Pickle, even drove the kid to a smoke shop to buy the detox pills. Another recruiter, Sergeant Lloyd Spears of Little Rock, allegedly even made fake diplomas himself on his own computer. Well, you see, he was in a big rush to sign people up to try and win a $10,000 bonus and a trip to the Bahamas. Which sounds like a prize for spinning the Wheel of Fortune, not finding soldiers of fortune. Now, these guys are under a lot of stress because they have quotas to hit, and drumming up leads is tough. Some recruiters just troll around, trying their best to relate.
Ladies, you ready to join up? You're in the ninth grade.
Yes, sir.
Man, you look older than ninth grade, so.
Yes, sir.
All right, here's my card.
Right now, there's somebody out there who wants to be a Marine but has no idea how to do it.
I don't know. I was probably going to try to get a little career music or something.
Career music. Maybe we can get you a career in music, you know, let the Marines go for it.
Yeah, man. Let the Marines go for it. You can write all their battle raps.
I'm sure you know who Shaggy is, right?
Yeah.
You know anything about him?
Yeah, he the Jamaican. Yeah?
How about a former Marine?
Oh.
Did you know it?
I love how this guy's body language is just, he couldn't give less of a fuck about Shaggy. While other recruiters just resort to driving around like a creep with candy in a van.
What school you go to, man? You don't go to school? You just look real familiar to me, man.
I came here.
You never came and talked to the Marines before? You sure? You want to talk to the Marines?
But Henderson, Nevada's own Staff Sergeant Clark seems like the kind of guy that I'd be willing to put my life on the line to save.
I knew the applicant, I knew the future soldier, and for lack of a better word, she was dumb.
I'll say this about this dude, he seems honest, and he says he's never lied to any of his recruits, even if he does look like a taupe became a person. He'll be the first one to tell you that Army recruiters do have quotas.
It's absolutely true that we do have a quota. We're expected to match that. It doesn't matter, it really doesn't matter if we make it or we don't make it. If I put 100 people in the Army, guess what? My boss comes in and gives me a pat on the back. Good job. Now go get some more people. If I put 0 in the Army, he gives me a 5-second lecture about trying harder.
But if that's true, then why do recruiters lie to future soldiers to keep their numbers up?
I'd rather just stay here, go to college.
But when he told that to Sergeant Glenn Marquette, a supervisor at the Greens Point recruiting station.
No, there's not a way for me. It's time to write a contract.
There's no way out.
No.
But that wasn't true. Take a look. These recruiting regulations say delayed entry members can leave any time, saying under no circumstance can a recruiter threaten or intimidate future soldiers.
What if I just don't show up?
And guess what? You're AWOL, absence without leave. You want to go to school, you will not get no loans, then they can apprehend you, take you to jail. So guess what? All that lovey-dovey, I want to go to college and all this, guess what? You just threw it out the window because you just screwed your life.
And this is widespread as hell, too. A news network sent 10 teens undercover into recruitment offices.
Nearly half of the recruiters who spoke to our undercover students compared everyday risks here at home.
You got a better chance of a shower in Jamaica Avenue.
To being in Iraq.
I like Subway sandwiches and Subway salad. And I watched news yesterday, a guy got killed in Subway.
Does this guy just not hear his own bullshit?
You have a 10 times greater chance of dying out here on the roads than you do of dying in Iraq.
I'd rather get hit by a car instead of getting hit by a bomb. What's the difference? You not living. You're dead. That sucker is gone. Is a rat.
That's great logic. You're gonna die anyway. Come die with us, you silly fucking idiot. And once you're in, recruits don't get treated any more honestly or fairly.
Four Marine sergeants are facing courts-martial for their role in the alleged abuse of recruits.
And I am the slowest talker of all time.
They can't choke them.
Absolutely not.
Can't slap them?
No.
Can they call them names?
They cannot.
I don't know why. I could watch this for hours. What if I shot a recruit out of a cannon?
Absolutely not.
How about giving the recruits a bunch of little kisses?
No.
Can I run them over with a Subaru?
Absolutely not.
But I'm talking a lot of shit for someone who's never actually served his country, so I figured I'd reach out to fellow comedian and Air Force soldier Garrett Hall.
Whenever I was joining, they were like, you weigh this much and you're this tall, so that's fine. I figured I'm going to go to boot camp, so I need to start working out. And so I gained like 10, 12 pounds. I go back and the recruiter's like, what have you done? Like, what do you mean? He goes, why did you gain all this weight? Be fat now. And I was like, what? Some of the best shape of my life. And he's like, I don't know if this is a workout, man, with you gaining all this weight. He's like, you're gonna have to lose all this weight. I'm like eating 500 calories a day, like trying to and just run it.
You're doing like Christian Bale in The Machinist, like you're just withering yourself.
Yeah. I come back the next week, right? And I've lost the weight and I just feel like absolute dog shit. And he's like, oh, your previous weight would have been fine. I just measured you wrong.
But those aren't even the craziest methods of recruitment that the military has used lately. The military spent millions on this bizarre traveling mall installation to give young boys the real feeling of shooting a machine gun indoors. This just looks like the most expensive school shooter simulator ever. I love how this kid keeps shooting while the reporter is talking.
People who are 13 years or older can come and they get to ride a simulated Humvee and shoot simulated rifles, and they're given a mission. They can shoot at people who come to attack them, and they lose points if they kill civilians.
Lose points with the money they spent on this fucking thing? You should be VR court-martialed.
I don't think younger people know the difference between dead and alive really right now.
And while it sounds like you ripped that out of this kid's poetry book, I agree. But the military doesn't care if you have a grasp on that yet. They just want you to join the fucking military.
Damn it! Even the dumbest teenagers in the dumbest town in the dumbest state know better than to join the army.
Well, we'll just have to go younger.
They realized that a huge way to get the army in front of young, impressionable eyes was through Twitch. Twitch, if you don't know, is a platform for watching others stream video games. Twitch has over 140 million unique users a month, and more than 65 million of those are under the age of 18. This has led to the Army having a huge footprint in esports advertising, starting their own esports teams, and even starting to stream on Twitch itself. I'm just out here waiting for Army Gamer Bathwater. CBS did a story on the Army's esports team.
Last year, the Army missed its recruiting goal for the first time since 2005.
Oh, they missed their recruitment goal, 2005. You mean when recruiters were doing all that fake diploma and detox pill shit? Wow, it's almost like every time they miss their quotas, there's actually repercussions.
So now Uncle Sam has a new strategy, going not just online, but into video games.
God, it's so cringy when these reporters go to these things.
I'm Snake from Metal Gear Solid.
At this sold-out gaming convention in San Antonio, people dressed up like their favorite characters, including more than a few make-believe soldiers.
This is where the Z-Gens are.
Major General Frank Muth, head of the Army's recruiting command, is looking for the next generation of American soldiers.
Spoiler alert, Hank from Breaking Bad, it's not this guy.
This is the kind of setup that you would imagine being able to begin a recruiting conversation.
Yeah.
Look at him trying to process that means he's talking to children in their bedrooms.
Yeah.
Now this professional Ryan Reynolds impersonator pretending to be a journalist has the chance here to ask a real, meaty, important journalistic question. Something that could be hard-hitting and impactful.
I'm gonna give you the questions from a typical recruit. You gotta give me the answer, okay?
All right.
Can I have a dog?
Nailed it. Now the military recently got in hot water because they were running fake contests over Twitch. Yeah, you heard me right, the Army's Twitch account would regularly do these giveaways for these pro-level Xbox controllers that cost upwards of hundreds of dollars. But when you click the link, you're given a recruitment page with no additional information, there's no end date for the competition, there's no details on your entry, there's just a sketchy recruitment form. Now Twitch rightfully came in and said per our terms of service, promotion on Twitch must comply with all applicable laws. This promotion did not comply with our terms of service, and we have required them to remove it. Pretty sad when a website for streaming video games has to come in and reprimand the United States military, huh? Also, their Twitch stream will automatically ban users that ask about war crimes. Will you stop asking about war crimes? I'm trying to play Cookin' Mama with John McCain and a drone. Now, apparently, banning people like this might be unconstitutional since they are, technically, the US government. An attorney at Columbia's First Amendment Institute said, "The government can't try to engineer the conversation of public by saying only people who agree with us can respond." She continued to say, "The First Amendment means the government can't kick someone out or preclude them based on their viewpoint." The US military responded by saying that bringing up war crimes was harassment, which was against Twitch's terms of service. Hey, stop cyberbullying the most powerful military the world has ever known. Well, yeah, they're sensitive. But one of the most unbelievable recruitment tactics is an entire video game the military developed to recruit kids. America's Army is a series of first-person shooters that is meant to generate interest in joining the United States military. The game was developed by the US government and distributed for free over the internet. The first version was released as America's Army Operations on July 4th, 2002, to an overwhelmingly good response. Now, you might be saying, well, come on now, the Department of Defense-funded shooter is not necessarily a recruitment tool. However, the Deputy Director of Development for America's Army admits that the game is exactly that, a recruitment tool. I mean, they got pretty carried away with making these games. They have a fucking arcade game. Most of the games have you playing as an unnamed new recruit, but one of the games actually gives your character a name, and that name is Roy LaCroix. I wouldn't beg the army for coming up with the most bitchin' name of all time, but holy shit, they did, and it's Roy LaCroix. Now, congressional testimony by US Army personnel claim that video games are actually their most effective recruiting tool, and quotes a 2008 MIT study finding that these video games had more of an impact on recruits than all other forms of army advertising combined. Yet, in this video, they're having a career day at an elementary school and using video games to clearly hook the young kids. In August 2008, protesters rallied outside Ubisoft headquarters in protest against America's Army. The protesters claimed that the T14 rating of the series was in violation of an international law, making it illegal to recruit people under the age of 17 to the Army. A Canadian punk band even made a song protesting the game. You can tell they're Canadian punks because they're really sweet.
Thanks for coming. We really appreciate it.
China saw the success of America's Army as a recruiting tool and decided to create their own propaganda game, Glorious Mission. Glorious Mission has been used to recruit potential soldiers for the People's Liberation Army, as well as to train and educate current PLA combat troops. Glorious Mission accurately recreates all the details, firearms, uniforms, and vehicles used by the People's Liberation Army. Does that make you any more uncomfortable than America's Army? It shouldn't have, because these two games are using the same tactics. In my opinion, America's Army is even worse, since it was distributed for free and there's fucking six of them. Now, screenshots have even been posted online where it appears both the Army and the Marine Corps have stooped as low as to create fake dating profiles on Tinder and Bumble. Yeah, we're not invading Iraq, we're just sliding into Iraq's DMs. Nevertheless, if the user swipes right on a recruiter's profile, the recruiter starts a conversation with them about their potential interest in the Army or the Marines. See if they're down for a little basic training and chill. As this Marine Justin posts this in-uniform thirst trap where he has all the charisma of a tub of yogurt. Now, I have to say allegedly in this section because I'm not sure if they were ever fully caught, seeing as some of these recruiters' pictures were lifted from other people's profiles, and it's hard to pin down exactly who did this. However, there is another story that has, unfortunately, too much proof. Our Army recruiters have been caught sexually assaulting some of the high school students they were trying to recruit. And they actually kept this scumbag on and kept using him for recruitment after this. The problem is clearly widespread, as this other case saw a victim being taken advantage of by two different recruiters. So I've tried my best to compile as many relevant facts as I could, and I know a lot of recruiters are straight up, and a lot of people join the military because they want to, because it offers stability, and because they can get themselves a better life. However, it's the treacherous techniques that I've outlined in this video that shows a pattern of overstepping appropriate recruitment boundaries. And I'm not sure where it goes from here, but my general opinion on most military issues is that they need some kind of outside supervision. I know we ended kind of heavy here today, so here's a pig riding a little ball. Yeah, that should make us about even. And by the way, if you guys have any ideas for future videos, shoot me a DM on Instagram. I'd love to hear them. Guys, thanks for checking out my video. I really appreciate it. Please like and subscribe. And if you like weird internet stories, check out my podcast, Extremely Internet, that I do about weird internet stories and internet culture. I also have a podcast called Development Hell about movies that were really fucking hard to make. So check them out. You'll probably like one of them. Thanks for watching, guys.